People that walked in darkness had seen a great light. On those who live in a land of deep shadow, a light has shone. For there is a child born for us, a son given to us, and a dominion is laid on his shoulders. And this is the name they gave him: Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. His power will never end. Peace will last forever. He will rule David's kingdom and make it grow strong. He will always rule honesty and justice. The Lord All-Powerful will make certain of all of this is done.
Love incarnate, love divine, star and angels gave the sign. Bow to babe on bended knee, the Savior of humanity. Unto us a child is born, he shall reign forevermore. Noel, Noel, come and see Noel, Noel.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph, and the virgin's name was Mary. He went in and said, "Rejoice, so highly favoured, the Lord is with you." She was deeply disturbed by these words and asked herself what this greeting could mean. But the angel said to her, "Mary, do not be afraid. You have won God's favour. Listen. You are to conceive and bear a son, and you must name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. God will give him the throne of his ancestor David. He will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and his reign will have no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this come about, since I am a virgin?" "The Holy Spirit will come upon you," the angel answered, "and the power of the Most High will cover you with its shadow." "I am the handmaid of the Lord," said Mary. "Let what you have said be done to me." And the angel left her.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoiced.
How Jesus came to be born. His mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, but before they came to live together, she was found to be the child through the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a man of honour and wanting to spare her publicity, decided to divorce her informally. He has made up his mind to do this when the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because she has conceived what is in her by the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you must name him Jesus, because he is the one who is to save his people from their sins. Now, all this took place to fulfill the words spoken by the Lord through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and we will call him Emmanuel, a name which means God is with us.
In the countryside close by there were shepherds, who lived in the fields and took it in turns to watch their flocks during the night. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and in the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified. But the angel said, "Do not be afraid. Listen, I bring you news of great joy, a joy to be shared by the whole people. Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. And here is a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly, with the angel, there was a great throng of the heavenly host, praising God and singing, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace to men who enjoy his favour." Now when the angel had gone from then into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." So they hurried away and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger.
After Jesus had been born at Bethlehem in Judea, during the reign of King Herod, some wise men came to Jerusalem from the east. "Where is the infant king of the Jews?" they asked. "We saw his star as it rose and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was perturbed, and so was the whole of Jerusalem. He called together all the chief priests and the scribes of the people and inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. At Bethlehem in Judea, they told him, for this is what the prophet wrote. And you, Bethlehem in the land of Judah, you are by no means least among the leaders of Judah. For out of you will come a leader who will shepherd my people Israel. When Herod summoned the wise men to see him privately, he asked them the exact date on which the star had appeared and sent them on to Bethlehem. Go and find out all about the child, he said, and when you have found him, let me know, so that I may go to do him homage. Having listened to what the king had said, they set out, and there in front of them was the star they had seen rising. It went forward and halted over the place where the child was. The sight of the star filled them with delight, and going into the house, they saw the child with his mother, Mary, and falling to their knees, they did give him homage. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things came to be. Not one thing had its being but through him. All that came to be had life in him, and that life was the light of men. A light that shines in the dark, a light that darkness could not overpower. A man came, sent by God. His name was John. He came as a witness to speak for the light, so that everyone might believe through him. He was not the light, only a witness to speak for the light. The Word was the true light that enlightens all men, and he was coming into the world. He was in the world that had its being through him, and the world did not know him. He came to own his domain, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God. To all who believe in the name of him, who was born not out of human stock, or urge of the flesh, or will of man, but of God himself. The Word was made flesh. He lived among us, and we saw his glory. The glory that is his as the only Son of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Joyful. When we are unsure, Lord, help us be calm. When information comes from all sides, accurate and false, help us to discern. When fear makes it hard to breathe and anxiety seems to be the order of the day, slow us down, Lord. Help us to reach out with our hearts when we can't touch with our hands. Help us to be socially connected when we have to be socially distant. Help us to love as perfectly as we can, knowing that perfect love casts out all fear. For the doctors we pray, for the nurses we pray, for the technicians and the caretakers and the cleaners and the caregivers we pray, for the researchers and the epidemiologists and for those who are trying to develop a vaccine, for all the key workers and teachers we pray, for those who are sick and those who are grieving we pray, for all who are affected all around the world. We pray for safety, for health, for wholeness. May we feed the hungry, give drink to the thirsty, clothe the naked and house those without homes. May we walk with those who feel they are alone, and may we do all that we can to heal the sick, in spite of the pandemic, in spite of the fear. We ask you to help and strengthen us as we journey towards Christmas and into the future. Amen.